My name is Gregory Tawa, and I head the TDB Modeling and Informatics subgroup. This presentation will demonstrate the impact of computation on drug discovery and design. As a further note, references will be made to modeler, bioinformatician, chemoinformatician, and statistician. These activities and the individuals who employ them come under the purview of the Modeling and Informatics subgroup. Our purpose is to use computation to help TDB project teams get drugs to the clinic as soon as possible. This involves the very difficult process of figuring out which compounds from the immensity of chemical space will be the handful of ones that go to the clinic. The array of experimental and computational activities brought to bear on this problem is vast. Computational activities should be in sync with experimental ones for the process to function efficiently. A huge variety of projects are supported or initiated and managed by modeling and informatics. Some example activities include HTS data analysis for early stage projects, structure-based drug design for mid-stage projects, in vivo experimental design for projects nearing IND, and bioinformatics and comparative oncology for projects initiated and managed by modeling and informatics. Early stage projects often begin with a high throughput screen to find active chemistry against the chosen disease. HTS is automated, producing a flow of data in the form of plate image heat maps, showing where compounds are active and at what concentrations. A chemoinformatician analyzes the plates, constructs dose response curves, and prioritizes compounds from most potent to least. These are then presented to the team to decide which compounds to further study. After HTS, medicinal chemists create analog hypotheses based on the original HTS hits that may be more potent. Using the target protein crystal structure, the molecular modeler will model the lead and all new designs into the protein binding site. The binding energy is computed. New designs predicted to be more potent than the original hits are synthesized by the chemists and tested by the biologists. A chemoinformatician analyzes the resulting assay data, constructs dose response curves, and sorts analogs most potent to least. Any analogs assayed that are more potent than the initial hit proceed to further rounds of optimization until the desired potency is achieved. In later stages, in vivo studies begin. Biologists need to know how many animals to use to resolve efficacy differences between treatment and control. A statistician will solve this problem by finding published experiments like the ones the biologists are planning. When found, a significance test is performed comparing treatment to control efficacy. If the efficacy difference is significant, the recommendation is to use the same number of animals as reported in the published experiment. If the difference is not significant, the statistician can run an in silico simulation, sampling more points consistent with the assumed normal distributions of the experimental data. The number of sampled points is increased until significance is achieved. The number of sampled points at this stage is equal to the number of animals to use in the currently planned experiments. External collaborations, initiated and managed by the Modeling and Informatics group, focus on comparative animal-human disease. To support these efforts, a combined experimental bioinformatics pipeline is employed to find disease targets and therapies valid in both animals and humans. It starts by obtaining animal samples from a biobank. RNA is extracted and RNA-seq is performed. Terabytes of sequence reads from RNA-seq are analyzed by a bioinformatician to determine differentially expressed genes. The data size is so large that analysis needs to be done on a powerful computer. The team employs the NIH BioWolf cluster, which is the world's most powerful supercomputer solely dedicated to biomedical research. The bioinformatician then performs a comparative analysis to find common genes between animal and human for the disease of interest. Tissue proteomics is performed to determine which common genes code for protein expression in tissue. For these proteins, a literature search is performed by a chemoinformatician to find antidrugs, which are drugs reported to influence protein expression in opposition to that exhibited by the disease studied. Drug combinations are assembled, cell-based matrix screening and synergy analyses are performed. Drug combinations exhibiting high efficacy and synergy are moved on to in vivo animal models with the eventual goal of getting these combinations into humans. Molecular modeling and informatics has impact across the continuum of preclinical drug discovery activities. Impact from the small set of projects highlighted today can be measured by contributions leading to 5 patents, 6 publications, 2 IND-enabling studies, 1 phase 1 study, 1 phase 2 study, and 17 anti-cancer drug combinations in current in vivo studies. Molecular modeling and informatics project impact is only made possible by finding and maintaining extensive collaborations, both within and outside of NIH. This emphasizes its importance in drug discovery.